I think all the seats are out now. It's a great day when you have to bring in extra seats. I don't know about y'all, but I am very excited to see a room full of people and back to a little bit of normalcy, right? Yes, it is going to be a great year. Good afternoon. My name is Lisa Miller, and I currently serve as the Vice President for Enrollment Management and University Relations. This is our university welcome, and for some of you, this may be your 40-something year to start an academic year, and for some of you, this may be your very first experience. So wherever you fall in between there, we hope that this is a great afternoon that kicks off an extraordinary year for you. Many of us have been here all summer long, working tirelessly to begin a great kickoff to the academic year 22-23. One of the things I often do to my staff when I feel like they're, you know, getting in the trenches and not having all the love and inspiration they need is I often ask them to get out a piece of paper and ask them how did they feel when they received the phone call that said they were going to be an employee at ULM. And it kind of takes you back and makes you think, how did I feel when I got that phone call? And so then we talk about it, and I often hear, I was very proud. Some people say, I was glad I could pay my bills. Now I have health insurance. We all have good reasons for wanting to work at a university, but my guess is because you want to change lives. You want to make a difference in the students who are giving their time and their money and their energy to better themselves. And it is because of you that we can make that happen. So thank you for being a part of our family. I have some special people here with us today that I'd like to introduce because they have become very involved with almost everything we do here. It seems like we need parking places for them, or at least parking decals, because they're here so much, and it's certainly great to see them. We have our Honorable Mayor, Mayor Friday Ellis. We have Representative Adrian Fisher. Where are you, Adrian? I know you're here somewhere. Who has some children here, right? We're educating his children, so that's great. An alumni of the university, Kelsey McCrary, with the City of Monroe. Kelsey's back there with DJ, also an alumni of the alumnus of the university. Hannah Livingston, another alumni of the university, representing U.S. Kennedy, Senator John Kennedy's office. Tana Trischel from the Northeast Louisiana Economic Alliance. Representative Mike Eccles. Where are you, Mike? I know you were here. You were one of the first ones here. There's Mike, also an alumnus of the university. Stuart Cathy, Senator Stuart Cathy. Here you are, Stuart. He'll keep me on my toes up here. Chris Kelly, representing the West Monroe West Wasatch Chamber of Commerce. We're glad to have you here today. And Janet Durden from the United Way, one of our just strong partners. Thank you, Janet, for always being here to support us. So when Dr. Arant began to think about what he wanted to do at this university welcome, he really wanted for you to have an opportunity to hear from all of the leaders of campus, to hear what was going on in each of our areas. I truly believe each one of you are an ambassador to this university, and the more knowledge we can equip you with, the better we're going to be as a university. So today, I get the honor of kicking that off to talk to you about my area. I currently oversee enrollment management and university relations, and we have the honor of informing and inspiring people about this beautiful university located here on Bayou Desired. As of today, we continue to enroll students for this fall semester. And this morning, we welcomed over 100 international students, the largest group of new international students we've ever had in the history of the institution. So we're very excited about that. The energy and the enthusiasm those students brought to the room was truly contagious. We are all very excited and hopeful that following a two-year pandemic, our enrollment will begin to stabilize and we can begin to implement our plans to accomplish the goals set forth in our new strategic plan. We are a very competitive group and we're up for the charge. Our recruitment team will visit every high school in the state of Louisiana, as well as contiguous counties in our neighboring states. We have a recruiter who will focus primarily on our underrepresented population. He will work all of Northeast and Northwest Louisiana, as well as anywhere else that he has the call where he needs to help a student. We serve 30% of our freshman class will be first-time students to go to college. We feel like that's part of our mission. Browse on the Bayou is right around the corner. It's going to be early this year because we want to get the word out as soon as possible before students have an opportunity to visit any other campus. So on September the 24th, the same day we will beat the Raging Cajuns, we'll also be welcoming a group of prospective students. We will also be hosting Take Flight Nights in targeting cities, as well as working with academic programs across campus to highlight these programs to our students in our area. This past year, we implemented a new tool called My Majors that allows students to take an inventory that surveys their interest and their strengths and matches them to programs that we offer here at ULM. This has allowed us to be very strategic in our communications with our students. We stuck our toe into that a little bit last year, and we are really ready to go this year. I am very happy to tell you that out of our ACES Place office, and I'll give you this number in case you are in ever a question, because I can promise you they can answer it. 342-7777. You can't forget that, right? They are help on call. They have this year executed over 235,000 communications, either phone calls, text messages, or emails to our students. So they are busy as bees, to say the least. We will also increase our efforts in community colleges, not only in the state of Louisiana, but also Mississippi, Texas, and Arkansas. And this year, we have a recruiter who actually lives in South Louisiana and will be working the Baton Rouge and New Orleans area, as well as Baton Rouge Community College and Delgado. So we're very excited to see what that yields for us. Now I'm going to talk about one of those areas that's kind of an unsung hero. Our financial aid team has processed 11,025 FAFSAs. You heard me, 11,025 FAFSAs. And we have awarded $86 million in state and federal aid to over 5,800 students. Let's give them a round of applause. We were awarded an additional $900,000 in GO grants this year because the team has been so diligent in awarding to our students in need last year. So they gave us the largest additional increase of GO grant. That's free money for our students in need for the financial aid office to award. The registrar's office has tirelessly worked to ensure that we have a seamless registration process and that all your classrooms are secure. In addition to maintaining all of the official student records, they've been working nonstop on preparing to implement DegreeWorks, a new automated degree audit system, as well as banner document management. This allows all of our records to be digitized and for us to have an electronic workflow, which will promote effectiveness and efficiency. Our scholarship office has also been very busy. This year, we'll be awarding 66 Top Hawk scholarships. This means 66 of our freshmen have earned at least a 30 or above on the ACT. Our freshman class will be the recipients of $1.4 million in scholarships, and the office also maintains and awards the total scholarship budget, which is $9 million. So they work very, very hard. I also want to talk to you about our university relations area because we continue to strive for the importance of one university and one brand. Together, we are better. We are stronger when we are one ULM with one identity. This area is responsible for promoting your accomplishments. They have produced two magazines and more press releases, press conferences, groundbreakings, and ribbon cuttings than I can count, and there are many more to come. They maintain all of our social media platforms and communicate with the local media throughout the year. We also manage all those fancy Access TVs. How many of you were excited to see that big board this morning when you drove into campus on the hub? It was beautiful, right? Yeah, we're all excited. In addition to all of those things, we were able to add a new position in our area this year. Jamie Hanks is our new Community and University Relations Officer, and it has allowed us to build very strong relationships with our community partners that we think is going to end up yielding us some great benefits. So that's it from University Relations and Enrollment Management, and now I'm going to, I think, draw to give away my door prize. That Dr. Arant, I walked up, he goes, did you bring your career week? I said, I did, but I left it in the car. But I went and got it, because you're going to need some caffeine to keep up this year. Everybody ready? 353-6663. I probably could have said those last three numbers, huh? 663? Those three sixes made me really nervous. Yoo-hoo! There we go, a winner. Dr. Arant is now going to draw the door prize for Dr. Graves. Drum roll.
353-6642.
Somebody must have been close. Next, we're going to hear from Dr. Mike Camille, who oversees our information and student success area.
For those who are, that's not a Keurig. That's actually a $50 gift certificate to the bookstore. So Dr. Graves wishes he could be here, fell under the weather at the last minute, but he does want to reiterate to you the soundness of this institution. His team has been working very hard to get us a good budget. He says we're in a great place. He would love to be here, but as I said, he fell under the weather as we came. So with that, Mike.
Thank you, Dr. Arant. I don't really have any prepared remarks, but I just wanted to say how fortunate really I am to be in a division that focuses on information services and student success. We have a lot of interesting work coming up. I know that working with folks in both groups that we're excited about the strategic plan that the university has unveiled, and we've aligned our strategic plans accordingly. So there's a lot of activity going on in the Student Success Center. In fact, you'll see our strategic plan looks a lot like the university one. We're excited about all the energy that's coming from the other divisions, and we're really looking forward to the partnerships that are going to arise out of this this effort. On the information services side, IT, we've got a really big project going on. I think a lot of you know about this. What we're trying to do is to take all of our paper products, or we want to go paperless. We want those forms that you fill out where you grumble as you're doing it, you hit the print button and you walk to the printer, you sign it, you walk it, or you send it campus mail somewhere. All those different process steps takes a lot of time. So we're going to automate all of that, and we're gonna do it using one of the Ellucian products. It's a couple of add-ons from our Ellucian platform. So a lot of you are familiar with it. If you're not yet, you will be very, very soon. This fall is an interesting time, it's an important time for us, because by the end of the year, we will be going paperless. So those forms that you filled out that you grumble about, well, you don't have to worry about that. We're going to do all that through this platform. So whether it's Ellucian workflow Lucian, Banner Document Management. Degree Works, a degree audit that is even better than the degree audit that we're using. Well, we really don't have a degree audit right now. We're using FlightPath as an advising assistant, but we're going to have a true degree audit very soon. So if you could be patient until the end of the year and bear with us, because a lot of you are going to be involved in some heavy lifting along the way, I think you're going to really be happy with what 2023 looks like in the way that we operate. So really an exciting time for us. And just wanted to thank the folks who are in my division, because they're all, you know, they do all the work, and I get a little bit of the credit. So that's good. I'm so happy that they do the work, and it's just a pleasure to work with them. So I think that what I need to do is to pick up, is just, okay. I need some help, obviously, in many different ways. Okay, so, all right. Pick out a coupon.
Read the number.
Okay, read the number. I need my glasses for this one. All right. 353-6601. All right.
And for those keeping score at home, Mike, to alleviate some of the pressures of society, actually chipped in for a $50 gas card.
So next up is Dr. Valerie Fields, Vice President for Student Affairs.
Thank you, and good afternoon to everyone. If you received an email from me on Mondays, you know this is Mountain Moving Monday, and so we're very excited to be here. And in the Division for Student Affairs, we have been using our unlimited lenses to engage with our students and our community. First up would be our area of auxiliary enterprises and student services, where we have the bookstore, and we have been working very diligently with Stacy and her crew with the Warhawk Bundle, which is new to us. I think it did come to us as somewhat of some concern at first when some of the things came out, but we are working with the Barnes and Noble's team, and also with our Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Arant, and our Provost, to work with our faculty and staff members to try to iron out these kinks so that we will have a seamless process as we move forward with the Warhawk Bundle. It is a savings to our students, and I think we have just about 1,700 students that have signed into this program. Campus mail will be delivered, or it will have started to be delivered on today. And so the graduate assistants and students are all back. So for those of you who have been looking for your mail, it should be coming through very soon. So give us about 2 or 3 days to iron those kinks out. The WITS office has also returned to its normal business hours. It was open from 9 o'clock to 4 o'clock on Friday and Saturday to service our students, but we should be up and running back at our hours. IWTP with Ms. Georgia Sanderson. We have been working with Delta Community College. We have about 75 migrant workers that we work through a HEP grant, and we are very excited for that partnership with Delta Community. We also have partnerships with CenturyLink and Chase. And because of those partnerships, President Berry has assisted IWTP with championing 2 baccalaureate programs that will increase those individuals with their education. If any of you were out and around last week or so, we have a white glove program that we do with Residence Life and Housing. This program is where we invite community stakeholders to the university along with some of our personnel, and they come in and they go through the residence halls to make sure that they are prepared for our students. And so on this last time, we were able to show where we had updated the bathrooms in Madison Hall. And so for those of you who have not been over, it's a very nice update. And so it has really helped us with our housing on our campus. So we have just a little over 100 students who have arrived on our campus, and we have a record number of private rooms of about 236, and so that number is up since 2007. We're expecting approximately 80 students between now and Wednesday. These are some of our upperclassmen who usually wait until right before school starts to come, so we will be looking for them. In this area, we also have what is called Hawk Art Therapy, and a lot of you have participated in some of those programs. They've had the Sweet Tooth Tuesday, the Mixing Bowl, and Hawk Art Painting with Pam, so we're very excited about that. In the Environmental Lab, we've had 6 additional tests that have been added to our scope, which has been a savings of about $30,000. The first time that this lab was accredited was in 1998, and we're happy to share that we received our renewal this year, 2022. And we've also been able to hire a graduate from our biology program who is now serving as an analyst in that area. So I think that deserves a round of applause. The men and women who serve the Self-Development Counseling and Special Accommodation Center. It used to be called the Counseling Center. The students didn't like the name, the Counseling Center, so we renamed it. So we started out with self-development, then we went to counseling, and then to the Special Accommodation Center. These men and women have been working tirelessly with our community and with our students on campus. We've been able to add 3 additional counselor positions in that area, and one has been set aside to work directly with our athletic department, and so we're very excited about that. We were able to create the special accommodations coordinator to assist with facilitating the special needs of our students on our campus, and that number is also growing, so that position is really assisting us as we welcome our students to our campus. We have been able to champion around 337 student workers on our campus that was servicing about 57 departments, and 41 of those students worked in our Child Care and Development Center. So just to let you know, 337 student workers is a big help to 57 departments that are here on our campus. So we're very excited to have those students working with those departments. What was once known as Career Connection or Career Center has now been reframed. It is now the Career Development, and it has merged with Student Development which used to be Student Life and Leadership. So now we have what is called Career Development and Student Development. And that area is working really, really hard this week, because in the Student Development area, we still have our Campus Activities Board. And of course, I know you've seen all of the activities that have been out for Week of Welcome. And also they have the RSOs there, which we have probably about 100 of those. In the career development part, we have a mentorship program where we're excited to say that 60 students have signed up for that program. So we need all of the faculty and staff members to come aboard and help us as we help these students and galvanize them with becoming great leaders on our campus. One of the comments that we received was from a pre-health science student, and they shared how meaningful and helpful it was through research, internships, and other things that they learned from their mentor. So we're very excited about that, and we look forward to others joining us with the mentorship program through career development. Also, right now, this week, these first 2 days, we have been working with Academic Affairs with the Warhawk Way Summit. And this morning, I think we had right around 300 freshman students that were here. And tomorrow, we look for about 300 or so more that will be coming on board. And they came with lots of energy and enthusiasm. So we were very excited about that. And don't forget about our Warhawk wardrobe, because that is certainly being used, and that is a great way for our students to receive those items that they may need to prepare for those interviews that they may go on, or either if they just need some things to lighten up their wardrobe while they're here on campus. Event services has been exceptionally busy, as you can see. We're back in Bayou Point now, and between there, the hangar, and the president's home, the old president's home, they have been making lots of reservations and just helping everyone. The Office of Student Advocacy and Accountability has implemented for the first time ever a sexual assault awareness week that had over about 300 participants, so we're excited about that. And they were host their first annual Foster the Flock Resource Fair, and they have over 35 vendors on campus where they provided support to our students. 100 or less conduct cases, so that says to us that we have lots of students on our campuses, however, our conduct is lessening, so I'm very excited about that. In recreational services, they sponsored the Biggest Loser. On last year, there were about 185 participants, and that was an increase of, I think, about 109 individuals that had participated on last time. With that, we have expanded recreational services a little bit. Of course, it includes the intramural sports and also our wellness, but now they are also hosting our spirit groups. And for the first time, we are now championing the spirit groups with NCA and NDA, and they did a really great job at camp on the summer, where they did get second place in our division, and then the cheer did win first place with crowd cheer. So I think that also deserves a round of applause, because we haven't done that in a while. And the last group, and I hope I didn't skip anyone, that I would like to share with you is the University of Police. And so they are going to be coming to us, and they are talking about ADD, active shooter, avoid, deny, and defend. So they have been going all over the place training individuals, about 17 different trainings in our community, and they've had over 1,000 members that they have touched with organizations such as St. Francis Hospital, Graphic Packaging, and others. And so we're very excited that when our time comes, we decided that we will kind of do a delay for our campus, and so they will be getting information out to you. Along with that, we do have what is called CERT, and that's our Campus Community Emergency Response Team, and that team is the first campus program, and it has been highlighted throughout the state of Louisiana, and we're very excited about that. And our Lieutenant Governor wants to use ULM Campus CERT as a model for all of the universities in our system. So we're really, really excited about that, and I think that Mark and Ms. Bonner and their team deserve a round of applause for that. And lastly, we have two programs that move out of the Division for Student Affairs, and that's Sipping Tea with the VP that usually meets on Thursdays, and Tuesday Ties with the ULM guys. And those programs have brought significant information from our students, and it has been very helpful. We look forward to working with everyone. I've asked them to work across lines to make sure that we're meeting the needs of all of our students, and we're very excited to do that. So thank you all so much, and have a great rest of the evening. So we decided that we would toss this up a little bit. I think someone gave away a gas card. We want you to be able to use what we provide to you in whatever way you would like to do so. All right. So the ticket number is 353-6542. 6542. Mark, I'm going to get to keep my money. 6542. Nobody? Oh, wow. Do I need to pull another one? Last four numbers are 6542. Okay. We'll try it again. This is the last time, and I'm going to take my bag back because I can use it. The last four numbers are 6548. 6548.
right now I serve many hats. The most important one is I've got to be fast so I can get to the president. But my name is Mark Arendt, and I have the honor of serving this great institution as the provost and vice president for academic affairs. This is my second stint as ULM, and really, it's as if I've never left. My update from academic affairs is really going to be generic, because I could go through a lot of statistics to show you how great we are. But I'm looking at why we're great. Everyone in this room advances the mission of this institution in ways that you possibly can't imagine. And I'm probably stealing a little bit of what the president's going to say, so I'm going to be really brief so I don't do that. But academic affairs is going to be going through a season of academic planning next year. Right now, I've got approximately 25, there may be more, individual committees that is going to look at a number of aspects of academic affairs. Our new strategic plan commands us to change lives, because that's who we are. And in order for us to change lives, then we've got to be sure that we're changing them in the right direction. And we need to know that we're doing the right thing. And it's a tremendous honor and a great privilege to be able to lead a division that is so impactful. And I know that this will be successful because you will make it so. Now, as we go through these discussions, we're going to be doing a workshop in September with Gray Associates, which we're going to review our entire academic portfolio. All degree programs are going to be looked at to determine where our greatest strategies lie. And I will tell you before the rumor or the libel mill gets out that it is no intention here to cut programs. I don't like doing that. Our job is to take our strengths and make them stronger. And that's what we hope to give to the faculty by doing this workshop, is the data and the information to take that and grow in new ways that are possible. Other things we're looking at include areas such as disaster management and becoming an international authority on helping people recover from tragedy. We're looking at things like agriculture, new ways to use drones, both aerial and underwater. All of this will come out in our planning as we go through next year. To do so, we're going to have to revise the way we conduct business. One great failure of an institution is to go through a tremendous strategic planning process and expect your old ways to accomplish your new goals. We've got to make some changes. And already those have begun. ULM Online is transitioning into an office of online student advocacy, where we're beginning to merge online and face-to-face education, because that's the future of higher education. We want to be at the forefront of taking care of our families and to making a difference to everyone that walks through that room. This morning, you should have seen those 300 freshmen. You can't imagine the stories that are present before you. To hear them talk about their aspirations and their goals. Some of those people in this room could be the very next president of the United States, and we have to act like every one of them will be. So that will be my update for academic affairs. It is, again, a tremendous honor to serve you. I will now do my door prize. Now, everybody had really picked all the neat ones, okay? So LaShonda and I were trying to figure out what we were going to do. And I said, LaShonda, what's the most valuable thing on campus? And without blinking, she said, the fried chicken. So she worked her magic, as she usually does, and we were able to get a $50 credit for some individual to the cafeteria to eat as much fried chicken as you want to. The ticket number is 353-6732. Three, five, three, six, seven, three, two. Any takers?
Going once. Going twice.
Okay, we'll try it again. All right, try number two. 353-6565. One last thing before we invite the president to come up to talk. Part of this is a welcome, and we're welcoming a lot of new employees here. So if you are a new staff member, would you please stand? Staff member. Thank you. If you're a new faculty member, would you please stand? The president's going to invite you to a reception afterwards. People you don't recognize, talk to them, because they're probably going to be your family member for the next many, many generations. So with that, I'll turn it back over to Lisa.
So I do want to tell y'all a little bit about the t-shirt. Our very first home football game, so we bought 200 t-shirts for the first 200 people who got here today, and this will be the official white-out t-shirt you wear for our first home football game. And don't fret if you didn't get one. Where's V? There's V Dickey. She has some for sale for you if you still need one or you want to dress your entire family in a white-out t-shirt. So hope y'all enjoy wearing those and bring your spirit to the game. There's probably somebody in the audience right now very nervous because he's like, why did she get back up there? She knows I hate introductions. And I've learned one thing in my past 18 months. I won't do a big introduction. Please join with me in welcoming our ninth president, President Ron Berry.
Thank you, Lisa. Boy, what a great day to be a Warhawk. Boy, it is exciting today, isn't it? Yeah, so I have to apologize right away. No one told me that I needed to do a door prize. So Christine and I are gonna do better than that. We're gonna cover the bar. So we're gonna buy you a drink. So feel free to help yourself. Now, I have to tell you, I was going to ask the bar not to open until after I spoke, and you'll figure out why in a minute, but I missed that opportunity because I saw some of you already drinking, but that's okay, that's okay. It is very exciting to be here, and it's super exciting to see all of you. I love the fact that we had to bring more chairs in. The only thing that I'm disappointed of, and this is not a complaint, this is a, and I'm going to talk about this later in my discussion with you, Wayne Gentry back here and his team do a phenomenal job for us doing all these live stream events, and so at Pursuit, which was the end of our road show, I got up to speak, and Lisa knows I don't like introductions, so they changed it up on me a little bit. So they got up here and said, okay, instead of introducing him, we're going to tell some things about him that you might want to know. And I said, okay, that's not about me. And so they got up there and they said crazy things like, you know, he really likes beer. He really likes ice cream. And so I got up trying to make fun of it and said, yes, so all you men know now how you get a figure like mine. I won't charge you for that advice. But afterwards, Wayne told me that he was going to get a filter to take about 15 pounds off of me. And so I walk in and immediately he says, Dr. Berry, I forgot it. It's at home. So Wayne, I hope that next time we have that filter and we're all good to go. Thank you, sir. We do appreciate all that you and your team do for us to make our brand fantastic. So last year at this event, we talked about our individual and collective purpose. We talked about why. Why do we do what we do as a university? And it was kind of cool. A lot of people talked about it afterwards. A lot of people did some introspection and thought about what it is they wanted to do with their life and how that fit in with the university. It was really quite awesome. And so we took that and we built a strategic plan. Seth Hall led us through that process, a strategic plan that pushes the boundaries, that set audacious goals like raising $250 million by 2031. We went around this summer, around the South, and we talked to people in New Orleans, in Baton Rouge, in Shreveport, in Alexandria. We went to Houston. We went to Dallas. We went to Denver. We went to Chicago. And we told them all about this strategic plan. We talked about our vision. We talked about how we have decided that we are going to change lives, that that's our purpose. And people got excited, and they wanted to join us. And now we've got people from these cities restarting alumni associations because they want to become re-engaged. We met people in Denver who said, I want to come to campus. I want to be a part of what's going on. I want to talk to students. I want to be on boards. I want to give you money. At the very first one in Shreveport, a man said, I want to be a part of this. Here's $80,000. It's exciting to be a Warhawk. It really is. And I am the most fortunate person in the world because I get to go around telling these stories about you and how good you are and what you do for our students and how you believe in that shared purpose of changing lives. It's big, it's meaningful, it's rewarding. And then the obvious question becomes, what's next? So today, I want to take you on a little journey on what's next. So from the beginning last year, our theme really was about our why. And collectively, we decided that it's time to own who we are, where we are, and what we must do. It's time to accept who we are. It's time to accept the people that we serve, the region that we live in, and what we need to do to give every single person in our region the opportunity to be the best version of themselves, to have opportunities that they've never dreamed of, for us as a university collectively to lift people up, to lift them out of poverty, to change their future life direction and generationals that follow them. So the question is, what's next? So obviously we've got who, what, where. The next things are when and how. And we've all heard that before, right? Who, what, when, where, and how? We've heard that before. The when is easy. The when is now. The how? Well, it's a little complicated. It's a little difficult. But all of you have, especially the teachers in the room, what's that old saying? Tell me, I'll forget. Show me, I might remember. Involve me, I'll understand it. So we're going to do something a little different. Last year was very different, right? I didn't get up here and talk about statistics and tell you that our legislators did an amazing job for us this year. We could not have asked them to do more. That they actually got us full funding for our new Sugar Hall renovation. Unbelievable. When we went to them and said, hey, we need $4 million more, they stood up for us and got that $4 million. I didn't tell you that Jamie Hanks and a group of us went to Baton Rouge and met with Commissioner Dolanin and said, hey, you know, we're struggling. We really need extra money. We got some generator issues. We've got some HVAC issues. We walked out of the room with $500,000. That's because of the relationships that have been built. That's because of your friendships, your connections to other people, our legislators going to bat for us. I didn't talk about the unbelievable biomedical research and innovation park that we're part of, that our legislators, again, our mayor, our police jury, our chambers, our city, the governor got involved and said, hey, we believe in this. We're going to give you $2 million this year, and we're going to put $19.5 million in Priority 5 funding for you. That's amazing. I'm not here to talk about that, but it's unbelievable. I'm here to talk about how. And so I need some volunteers, and now you'll understand why I wish the bar hadn't opened when it did. But I'm looking for a few, two really categories of people. I need somebody who's interested in getting out of their comfort zone to join me on stage. And then I need somebody who is unbelievably full of energy. And then a couple of more people who want to join them. Do what? Who? Come on, Crystal. Come on. Come on. Come on. All right. So you're the energy person, right? Okay. So Ahmad, I think you're the other energy person. You don't have a choice. Come on, Ahmad. You're going to be the uncomfortable one? All right. Cool. 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 All right. All right. Awesome. All right. So I need one more uncomfortable person. One more uncomfortable person. Okay, I'm very uncomfortable, so I'll be that person. I won't put anybody on the spot. So the how is kind of challenging. And I'm about to show you how. Okay? All right. So I'm going to tell you what to do. And you're going to do it. Right? Okay. Then you are going to tell them what to do, and they're going to do it. Okay? Now, I need everybody to stand up for me. Stand up for me. Okay. If you can, stand up. I know some of you were at that bar quite a few times. Okay. All right. So I'm going to put the mic down. I'm going to tell them what to do. Then they're going to tell you what to do, and we're going to keep doing it. Okay? Everybody understand the rules. Here we go.
Very uncomfortable. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Keep going.
Keep going. All right, do I need to do it again? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Watch again. Watch again. Come on, y'all.
Do it.
Okay, so for all the older people in the room, what's the music that goes with this? We will rock you, rock you. Yeah, okay, all right, thank you. That was awesome, unbelievable. That's it. All right, so see how easy leadership is? See how easy how is? I tell somebody how to do something, they tell somebody how to do something, and you do it. That didn't take long at all, did it? Did that take long? Not only did it not take long, it was what? It was fun, right? It got the blood flowing. I started to say, add a little, you know, but I didn't want to do that. That might have been a little bit too much. So that's the end of the presentation. That's how we do it. Not really, right? Obviously, not really. Now, if you think about that, who makes the one decision? I did, right? I can promise you I'm not the smartest person in the room, without doubt. But all I did was tell a group of people what to do, who then turned around and told somebody else what to do, and you did it. You conformed. We created conformity. You did exactly what I asked you to do. And we achieved something. We really didn't achieve a whole lot, right? Because I can't sing. I can't stay in rhythm. There's a better way. There's a much, much better way. And that's what we want to talk about today. The real how. And we're going to talk about the 30,000 foot view of how. Because sometimes as a nerd, as a computer information system person, as a recovering accountant, I get stuck in details. I don't get out of the trees, and I get really stuck. And sometimes it's good for all of us to take a step back and look from above so that we can look at things differently. Okay? So did anyone notice the music that was playing when you came in? Anybody? Is anything unusual about the music? No? Okay, the music was actually by a very unique group called Orpheus. Has anyone other than our music faculty ever heard of the Orpheus Orchestra? Amazing group. They've been in existence since the 70s. Okay, now I want to show you this very short video, and I need you to pay very, very close attention to what's going on. And I want you to think differently as you look at it. I want you to think of what is normally in an orchestra, what's going on in an orchestra, and then tell me something that's different. Okay, anybody notice anything strange? Anything different? Do what? Tap dancing. Okay, that's unusual. That's unusual, but you might see that occasionally. Anything else missing that you might normally see almost every single time? No conductor. There was no conductor there. In fact, that's what the Orpheus Orchestra is known for. They're known for bringing the most talented people together, the ones who have these unbelievable, unique skills, who can combine with other people and become something beautiful, something more impressive than they ever could become on their own. And they do that by creating an environment of mutual trust and respect. They never complain. They never gossip. As they're playing, they'll stop and say, wait, let's think about this. Let's do it this way. Maybe you should be a little bit later here and a little bit quicker here. The tempo needs to change. Without criticizing, without complaining. It's an environment where everyone shares the same goal, which in their case is creating beautiful music together. That's the how. No one in this room needs me to tell you what to do. Every one of you, you're brilliant. You're the most intelligent, part of the most intelligent group of people in the world. You work at an institution of higher education where you have the opportunity every single day to change a life, including yours or your colleagues, not to mention our students. So what are we doing here? I never use PowerPoint, so I'm challenged here. Oops, too soon. The 30,000 foot view. This summer, I mentioned to you that we went on the road show. We went all over the place. The people who did that did not know that it was an experiment. It was an experiment in collaborative leadership. I was not involved. I showed up when I was told to show up. I spoke when I was told to speak. But this was a unique event that combined the efforts of athletics, the foundation, the Alumni Association, marketing and communications, recruitment and admissions, and academic affairs. All who have their own leadership team, but we pulled people together and said, we want to accomplish something amazing, and we want to take it around the South and share our message. And you know what they did? They knocked it out of the park. They worked together. They worked collaboratively. They thought about the mission. They thought about the benchmarks. They thought about the purpose. And they came together as a group with no leader. I don't think anyone took complete charge of that program. They came together as a highly intelligent, highly capable group of individuals who had a shared mission of representing our university to our alums, to business community members, to prospective students, and they did it. Very, very impressive. Was it perfect? No. Do we have ideas for improving? Absolutely. But we're going to get to the point where we can do that openly with each other without being offensive, without complaining. That's the 30,000 square foot view. We have a shared passion and a purpose. We have a vision. And that vision is supported by a culture. And we started something Dr. Fields mentioned this morning. We're teaching our kids the Warhawk way. The Warhawk way is all about how we believe in each other. We trust each other. We support each other. We want to see each other succeed. That it's not about us as an individual. That it's us collectively. While also maintaining the very important fact that we can't do that if we don't take care of ourselves. And we don't look after ourselves. And we don't develop ourselves. So while we're working for our students, we're working for each other as well. Culture is extremely important. And of course, people. You got to have the right people. You're here. We've got it. No problem. Attitude. That's where the no complaining comes in. That's where the positivity replaces those kind of thoughts. And the psychologist in the room will probably tell you, if you complain, that does something to your brain. You start thinking differently if all you do is complain. Change the conversation. We all need to change the conversation and say, hey, I'm not going to complain. I'm going to make constructive comments. I know we can do better, and this is how we're going to do it. And it's going to be received appropriately. That's the 30,000 square foot view. 30,000 square foot view. That's very tall. And commitment and patience, and especially a commitment to patience. We are in the middle of a transformation. Transformations don't happen overnight. We're moving from someone telling you what to do for you to becoming owners of your positions, owners of your responsibilities, and part of a team that is empowered, part of a team that needs you to play your role so that we can be the university that we all want to be, which is by far, without a doubt, the best university in the world. Now, I have one more video that I'd like to share with you to kind of wrap things up. And this video is, well, first of all, this is my first attempt at editing a video. So don't complain, offer constructive criticism, okay? This video, for some of the younger folks in the room, you may not have seen it, but it's from the Dead Poets Society. This movie came out when I was in college, and it had a profound impact on my life. And I think it's very fitting to share a small part of that today because, first of all, the business that we're in and what we do and what we hope to do more of in the future, which is meet our students where they are, meet each other where we are, get to know each other and our students, help them remove that mask that we all wear, that mask that hides our insecurities, our fears. It's an amazing movie. If you haven't seen it, I encourage you to watch it. It's something that I think all of us can take something away from. So here we go. Here we go.
No matter what anybody tells you, words and ideas can change the world.
I'm Neil Perry.
I'm Todd Anderson.
We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. We read and write poetry because we are members of the human race, and the human race is filled with passion. Medicine, law, business, engineering, these are noble pursuits necessary to sustain life. Poetry, beauty, romance, love. Stay alive for
me sleep.
I stand upon my desk to remind myself that we must constantly look at things in a different way.
So the how. We all contribute a verse. No matter what that verse is, no matter where you are, no matter what your calling is, no matter what your mask is, there's a beautiful play that continues to go on. Our students need us each to play a verse. They need us to be the best versions of ourselves. They need us to meet them where they are. Our kids that we welcomed this morning were a lot like these kids in this video, full of hope and excitement But they also have masks on. They also need us to reach out to be the best that we can be. And we need each one of you to reach out to each other. You are some of the smartest people in the world, some of the most talented people in the world, right here in Monroe, Louisiana. An awesome place to live, an awesome place to have a family, an even better place to have a university that cares deeply about its people. It's time, really, to accept who we are and what we need to do and the verses that we're all going to play. It's a unique opportunity. And I can't tell you how proud and privileged and honored I am to be able to work with people like you who get it. People like you who are here in this region because you know the challenges. People like you who get up every day knowing that you're going to a place that still has challenges. We're still transforming. We're still getting to that place where we can all lead our best lives, where we can lead and be empowered in our own position. I promise you we're getting there. I just need you to be patient a little longer. It's going to be worth it. You're worth it. Please know how much I appreciate each one of you. I hate that I don't get to see most of you as often as I do. That's one of the bad things about being president. This is my fourth presentation today, and I'm surprised I still have a voice. But I would love to be in the classroom with you. I'd love to be meeting students with you, and hopefully they'll get to a point where I can do that. Because it's you who are making the difference. It's you who are playing those verses with these students and with each other. And it's you who's creating the opportunity for us to lift this community where it needs to be. So, thank you. Thank you for playing your verse. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being part of the ULM family. Thank you for being committed. Thank you for making a difference in the lives of others. Now let's have a drink.